The Houston Nutt era is over, but a new rivalry is born. This is our big story at 5 o'clock.
Sports director Mark Larrikos joins us once again, and Mark Nutt was introduced today as the new coach at Ole Miss.
Yep, sort of like finding out your dad is Darth Vader and Super Hog fans to get the official news today. The man who led their Hogs for 10 years all of a sudden now works for the Rebels. The press conference in Oxford, of course, loaded with big applause and cheers as Nutt outlined his goals and philosophy for the future. Many of his comments eerily similar to the ones he made on the Hill, like spelling fun, W-I-N, like you just saw, or talking about the idea of one heartbeat for the fans and players. As for the Rebels, well, they didn't improve very much under former coach Ed Orgeron. In fact, Ole Miss didn't even win a single conference game this year, and that helped lead to his firing. So officials are counting on Nutt and his proven track record to get their program out of the basement.
Our coaches, the coaches that come to Ole Miss, they're going to be difference makers. They're going to be difference makers in the lives of an 18, 19, 20-year-old. We want to win an SEC outright championship. We want to do those things. And
Nutt will make roughly $2 million per season, and he's expected to bring several of his Hog assistant coaches with him to Oxford, and says he's still interviewing candidates, and of course he's going to hit the recruiting trail this weekend, so it's going to be a busy time for Mr. Nutt.
For sure.
Okay, Mark, thanks.
Well, the coach is gone, but fans are still talking about the deal he took to leave.
Matt Barcaro joins us now live with our team coverage. And Matt, a lot of fans not happy about Nutt's buyout.
Yeah, those fans are talking to each other, calling into the sports radio shows, and posting comments on message boards. They're all riled up that Houston Nutt quit his job, but will still be getting money from Arkansas. Now, this all started on Monday when Chancellor John White was talking about Houston Nutt's contract, saying that when they wrote it up, they wrote it so it'd be very hard to break. He called it the golden handcuffs. There was a penalty in that contract if Houston Nutt were to resign before his contract. He'd have to pay the university $500,000. He'd also be out of all the money he earned up to that point. But Chancellor White decided to go ahead and give that money anyway. So he asked the Razorback Foundation to give Houston Nutt the money that was due to him, reported to be around $3.5 million, and also negate the contract break free so Houston Nutt could walk free. So he took the deal, and then the next day he signed on with Ole Miss, the SEC rival, and the fans who've been divided this entire season are again split on what to make of all this.
If I get fired from my job, I get unemployment. If I quit my job, I don't get anything. And if he's going to go ahead and just quit, then he shouldn't get any compensation.
He's been under a lot of pressure. He's taken a lot of stuff. So I think, you know, the chancellor and Broyles did right by him and, you know, took, like they said, took the cuffs off.
And the Razorback Foundation, which is the private fundraising arm of the athletic department, they would not comment on the contract itself. They said that's between the coach and the university. And Chancellor White said everything he wanted to say about the contract, he said on Monday. Live in Fayetteville, I'm Matt Barcaro, 4029 News.
Matt, thanks very much. 4029 has been asking for your opinion on Nutt's resignation.
And here are the results of our online survey so far. More than 1,500 people have voted. 966, or 62% of you, said you are ecstatic about the move. 18% are lukewarm about the resignation, and about, well, 20% of you are unhappy with this decision. You can also cast your vote. Just log on to 4029tv.com and click on the survey. It's right there in the middle of the page.